This conference will now be recorded.
Hello guys, welcome to Kumar Consulting. So guys, here in this session we are going to have a look on SAP navigation part. This is the third session. So now before going for the practical sessions, like doing multiple configurations, lots of configurations, first of all you need to be a bit familiar with SAP screen. I know some of you already will be having SAP software, so you might be knowing about these things, but most of you, whoever is beginner and first time going to learn this SAP, and also SAP screen will be quite new for those people. So this video is going to be very helpful for those people, guys. Just let's have a look on this. And apart from this, I'll tell you one more thing. Like Adi told you, like most of you are not having this SAP software and all. So in the next session, I am going to upload, in this is, it's already uploaded. Next session I have explained, in next video I have explained like how to install SAP in your laptop or desktops. So steps are quite easy. You have to watch the video, follow the steps one by one the way I have explained. Easily you'll be able to install the SAP on your desktop or laptop. After installations, I'll tell you guys, after installations, once the installation is done, then this kind of symbol SAP login pad will appear on your screen. And once you double click on this, then look at here, this kind of screen will appear. So here, how to log in, guys? Double click. So you'll be having only one. I'm having two server, it's okay, but you guys will be having only one. And how to configure this server and all, I have explained in details in that video. So now here, what you have to do, guys, you have to give your user ID. I'm going to give my user ID here, and then you have to enter your password here. That's it, and press enter. So once you give your user ID and password, then you'll be able to log in. Easily you'll be able to log in here. Now this is the first screen, guys. So look at here, multiple things are appearing here, like menu bar is there. Here certain things, in the sense this is called command box. So here I'll explain one by one. I have already taken the screenshot and I've kept here in my PPT. So look at here, this screen is going to appear. I think picture is a bit blur, but no issues. I'll explain here, and even I've shown that live server also. So now here, look at here, the first one is called menu bar, like menu, edit, favorite, extra, whatever these things are coming, that is called menu bar. The second one is called, here we are having command bar or called command box. Here in this box, what is happening, guys? Multiple shortcut key we are going to give here. Shortcut key is called transaction code in SAP language. What is this transaction code and how many transaction codes are there? These all things, guys, you will come to know once I start like configurations and all. Then multiple transaction codes I'm going to use, and you guys are going to be very much familiar with these all things whichever I'm explaining right now. Since it is first time, let's suppose if you are a beginner, then in that case, like I'm telling you the name of these all things, but once you start practice and all, then you need not to remember and mug up these names and all. Okay, so here you guys are going to be very much familiar with these all things, don't worry. Now this one is title bar. Title bar means like whichever screens, let's suppose you have logged into SAP and now you are going to do some configurations and all. So once you do the configurations, then what will happen, guys? Whichever screen is there, that screen name will appear, so that you will come to know, okay, this is defined company or company code or business area. So here the names are going to appear. This is called title bar. Now the next one is here, this is called application toolbar, right? Here we are having standard toolbar. Then at bottom we are having status bar, right? So multiple informations are there, guys. One by one you guys will, as I told you, like once we proceed further practically, once you are going to have a look on the things and also, you guys will be having a proper understanding. Now let me go on the next screen here. So I have shown the things in bit details here, like transaction code. Look at your transaction code box. This is called, as I told you, like here I have specified command bar, right? It is also called, here what we are going to give, guys, here we are going to give transaction code, right? So this is called transaction code box also. And if you click here, then what will happen, guys? It is going to be closed. I'll show you practically. Now, if you're going to click here, it is going to be closed. And this is called standard toolbar. Here, there is a use of each and every symbol. But As I told you that every symbols are quite easy. If you are familiar with MS Word or MS Office and all, then most of the things are already you have used over there also. The similar, the same use is there, like I'll explain here. So just let me show the main screen itself here, right? So now this is called your like transaction code bar, or else transaction code box, or you can say command bar, whatever. Here we are going to give certain transaction code. Let's suppose OX02 I have given. So if you give, this is your transaction code. Once you give and press enter, system is going to react. System is going to react. Look at here. Now in what to say, this is called your, like, look at here. So title bar, right? I told you, look at here, title bar. So this is what is appearing, title bar here. It means company code here, company code creation. What is this company code? How to set up these all things? As I told you, one by one, I'm going to explain these things so that you guys will be having a perfect understanding. Now, if you have to come back from this screen, look at here, back button is there. Click on that, we came back. If you want to, let's suppose you have configured something, if you have to save it, then we are having a save button, right? If you have to exit completely, log off, then we are having log off button. If you have to cancel something, this is what the cancel button, right? This is print, then we are having find. This is called find next. Find next. Now we are having, like, if you have to scroll up, scroll down, right? This is called, like, look at here. This is, if you are going to click here, then you'll be coming on first page. This is the last page, right? This is scroll up, scroll down. So as I told you guys, and here it is like create new session. Say for example, I'll just give once again OX02 and press enter. Now make it yes. Now, so create new session. Create new session means if you click here, then what is happening, guys? If you're going to click here, then we are already in one screen, and now another screen got open. We are already in one screen, and then another screen also got open. So multiple things are there, guys, and here look at, I'll show you here itself. Now in a status bar also, in a status bar, most likely I'll tell you. Now in a status bar, there is no much use of this status bar. Simply we are having some status informations here you can click. So now client details, your user ID, which transaction code you are going to use, these things are going to appear here, that you can see here also. If you click here, look at here, now status bar. So transaction code, user ID, client details, systems, these things will be there in the status bar and all. So as I told you that you need not to mug up anything here, because once you proceed further, these all things are going to be used automatically. Like let's suppose we are using Excel sheet, right? So here Excel sheet. So here also what is happening, guys, in Excel sheet, let's suppose if you have to find something, so Control F, find button came. Likewise in SAP also, either you can click here on, like, we are having, like, this is not highlighted here, but once it is highlighted, then you can click here on find button, right? You can click here on find button. I'll just do one thing, /NSPRO. I'll use, there is a use of /N/O also. These things you will come to know in once we proceed for the configurations. I'll let you know multiple shortcut key we are going to use, guys. So you guys are going to be very much familiar with those things. Okay, don't worry. Now here, let's suppose you are going to click on find button, or else Control F. Same use is there. If you want to search like something, you can type here and you can press enter, or else you can click here, continue, right? So likewise, there is use of these all things, guys. Here I have already specified in the PPT also. You come here, standard toolbar, look at here. Now this is called continue, this is called save. Here it is back button that already have shown you guys. Now then we are having, like, this is exit, this is cancel, then print, create new sessions, right? These are the help, find. So as I told you, now whenever we are going to proceed further for the configurations and all, then you guys are going to be very much familiar with these things. Simply the purpose behind of this session is to show you, like, okay, once you are going to log in, then this is called main screen. This is the first screen, right? Here also, like, from here, whenever you have to, like, if you are going to navigate for the configurations part and all, then what is happening, guys? You have to give, okay, so where is the configurations? all the configurations are here in this img. Okay, how we came here, guys? So come back, click on back button, and then click on back button. So once again, during practical session, I'm going to repeat the same, and then I'll explain the things in details. I typed like spro and press enter. Then I have clicked on reference img, and then this is called implementations guide. All the module, every module, whether it is finance module, controlling module, SD module, MM module, HR module, multiple modules, whatever the modules are there, all the modules configuration steps will be there in this implementation guide itself. Since we have to learn like FICO module and all, so we are going to have a look on those things one by one. We'll see lots of things. We are going to have a look, guys. We are going to see multiple configurations, right? So this is what, this is how you have to navigate into SAP. Although I have explained here, but you guys are, as I told you, like, you guys are going to be expert of these all things, because as I told you, like, multiple configurations we are going to do, and each and every configurations you'll be having uses of these all, whatever shortcut buttons I told you, or whatever the transaction codes are there, or whether it is path or transaction code, these all things are going to be explained in detail. Okay, so how to navigate to SAP, guys? Simply, you need to click on, double click on this SAP login pad. How the login pad is going to appear on your desk, on your desktop, login pad in the sense, this is called SAP login pad, this one. So how this is going to appear on your desktop, guys? As I told you, that I have recorded a separate video for this one, the next video, where I have explained like how to install this SAP. So once you watch that video, you will be able to install SAP easily. And if you are already having SAP installed, then no worries, then you might be having idea of these all things, whatever I've explained here, right? So in that case, you need not to, you can skip that video and you can watch the next tutorial. So it is for that, I have installed for the people who doesn't have SAP access, like they don't know how to install this SAP, they don't know how to access the SAP and all.